And now, in full color, from Hollywood. Frederick March. Basil Rathbone. Middleton. Bob Sweeney. Starring in Shower of Stars. Hollywood's brightest stars making their television appearance in full color. Brought to you by Chrysler Corporation, maker of these five great cars. Plymouth. Dodge, DeSoto, Chrysler, and the exclusive Imperial, Chrysler Corporation, the forward look. And now here is your host, Bill Lundigan.
Good evening. All of us know that Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol is a heartwarming story. And again this year, Chrysler Corporation is very happy to bring you this inspiring message on Shower of Stars.
£10.
Oh, wonderful! Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Scrooge and Marley, I believe. Do I have the honor of addressing Mr. Scrooge or Mr. Marley?
Marley's been dead these 7 years. He died 7 years ago this very night. That's Marley.
We have no doubt his liberality is well represented by his surviving partner. We are collecting for the poor.
As is the custom at this Christmas season.
What can we put you down for, Mr. Scrooge?
Nothing.
You wish to be anonymous?
I wish to be left alone.
Should we not at this time of the year make provision for the poor and the destitute?
Are there no prisons?
Plenty.
No workhouses?
Plenty.
No poorhouses?
Plenty.
I help to support these establishments. They cost enough. Those who are badly off must go there.
Many can't go there.
And many would rather die.
They'd rather die, they'd better do it. Decrease the surplus population. It's enough for man to understand his own business and not interfere with other people's. Mine occupies me constantly. Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Good afternoon. Indeed, good afternoon.
Cratchit, what do you want?
Some coal, you know, by my fire, sir.
You'll be gone 5 minutes. Let it go out.
Yes, sir.
Tidy up here before you leave.
Yes, sir.
Merry Christmas, Uncle God save you.
Ah, humbug.
Ho, ho, ho. Christmas a humbug? Uncle, you don't mean that.
I do mean it. What right have you to be merry at Christmas? You're poor enough.
Then what reason have you to be dismal? You're rich enough.
Bah! Humbug! Out upon Merry Christmas! What's Christmas to you but a time for paying bills without enough money? Time when you find yourself a year older and no better off. If I had my way, every fool who goes about saying Merry Christmas should be boiled with his own pudding and buried with a stick of holly through his fatuous heart.
Oh, Uncle Scrooge. Christmas is the only day of the long year when men and women seem to open their shut-up hearts and think of their neighbors as really fellow passengers to the grave and not just customers to be sold something at a profit. And so, whether I'm rich or poor, I believe Christmas has been good for me and will be good for me, and I say God bless it.
Let me hear another sound out of you, and you'll keep Christmas by losing your situation.
You're quite a powerful speaker. When you don't go into Parliament. Uncle, I came by to ask you to eat Christmas dinner with us tomorrow.
I'll see you in...
You know the place I mean. I'll see you there first. Good afternoon.
Well, I asked you in honor of Christmas, and I'll keep my Christmas humor to the last. Merry Christmas, Uncle.
Good afternoon.
And a Happy New Year.
Good afternoon.
Yes. A very Merry Christmas to you, sir.
And to you, Cratchit, and yours.
You really made my day, sir, with that speech to Mr. Scrooge.
Thank you. And the best to you all year long.
And to you.
Another one. 15 shillings a week and a wife and children. Talking about a Merry Christmas.
They're all mad.
I'll retire to Bedlam.
It's 6 o'clock, if you don't mind, sir.
You'll want all day tomorrow, I suppose.
If convenient, sir.
It's not convenient.
It's only once a year, sir.
Poor excuse for picking a man's pocket every 25th of December.
I suppose you must have the whole day. Mind you're here early the next morning.
Yes, sir.
Good
and a twinkle in his eye. It's...
Look, now you see him. Now he's gone by.
Santa Claus, Santa Claus, old Kris Kringle, old St. Nicholas, with bells on a jingle, with a Santa Claus suit and a Santa Claus nose, and something for everybody everywhere he goes, with a list in his hand and a twinkle in his eye. Santa Claus, Santa Claus, Santa Claus.
Humbug. Humbug! Kris Kringle. Old Saint Hypocrite. Old Jingle. Humbug soup. Humbug nose. Hand out for everybody, everywhere he goes. Calculated list. Things to give away. So he'll make a profit on Christmas Day. Humbug. Humbug!
Ready, and I turned your bed down. And good night, sir. Oh, by the way, I'm ready.
Don't say it!
I won't believe. He's been dead these 7 years.
What do you want of me?
Much.
You humbug! Or are you?
Ask me who I was.
Who were you then? You're particular for a ghost.
In life, I was your partner, Jacob Marley.
No doubt a bad dream. Brought on by something disagreeable that I dined on. Yeah. You may be an undigested bit of beef. Crumb of cheese. There's more of gravy than of grave about you, I'm sure of that.
I am nothing to you.
Nothing at all. I haven't heard it said in your lifetime, Jacob Marley, that you had no bowels. Now I see it is true. But that isn't proof enough.
Oh, God. Oh, God. The hard hearts of this world and the torment of years to come. I come out of torment. I come to help a soul avoid eternal misery. And I am not believed. Ebenezer.
Mercy, dreadful being! Mercy!
Why do you come to trouble me? We are sent to undo the evil we have done, to witness happiness we cannot share. The happiness that might have been.
But you wear a chain. Why?
I wear the chain I forged in life. A chain of useless things. The evil I did to others. Deeds of unkindness. The echo of empty houses. If you died tonight, Ebenezer, you would drag such a chain. Only longer, stronger.
What can I do, Jacob? Speak some comfort to me.
I have none to give. I have been traveling for 7 years, Ebenezer, on the wings of the wind, with the incessant torture of remorse. I have only begun to remedy the wrongs of our counting house. Oh, why did I walk at this season of the year through crowds of my fellow beings, with my eyes on the ground and my mind on my account books? Justice is done by the firm of Scrooge and Marley. Thousands of them. Thousands of them.
Don't be hard on me, Joshua.
You will be haunted by three spirits.
Three must be, son. I'd rather not, Jacob.
If you let them help you, you may yet shun the path I tread.
I've been having a nightmare.
I've been walking in my sleep. Molly, indeed.
Miracles in the hearts of men, as you will see in A Christmas Carol.
Now is the time for joyful giving. To give is the way to joyful living.
And what better way to combine the time for joyful giving, the way to joyful living, than a gift of one of these superb new station wagons of the Forward Look 56. For here truly is the gift that keeps giving and year-round driving pleasure. A thrilling, exciting gift that the whole family will enjoy. Distinctively smart and spaciously comfortable, with all the Chrysler Corporation advances in styling and engineering that have set a new high for performance and value in the entire automotive industry. Remember, no other station wagon on the market today offers you so many exciting and exclusive features. Push-button power flight, full-time power steering, and light sweep styling, to mention only a few, as do these town and country beauties of Forward Look 56. Now, there's still time to get delivery on the car of your choice, so why not make this time of joyful giving the way to joyful living with this very special present for your family that will help keep the spirit of Christmas in your hearts throughout the year. See your Plymouth, Dodge, DeSoto, or Chrysler dealer right now.
Let your heart be full. Keep on believing the spirit of Christmas through the year.
And now, the hour itself. 1 o'clock. I've only slept a few minutes. Most of the day. Are you the spirit I was to expect?
I am.
Sod. Layard. You resemble her so much. Which spirit are you?
The spirit of Christmas past.
What past?
Your past, among others.
What did you wish to see me about?
Your welfare.
I had so little sleep.
I am sent to save you from yourself. You have forgotten what the world is like for children. Come with me.
Yes, I am.
As you are.
Which way?
Take my hand.
No! Not that way. I shall fall.
Not when you're with me.
Thank you.
There's old Fezziwig, bless his heart, alive again. And Mrs. Fezziwig?
No, not alive again. This is Christmas past.
Dick and I were apprenticed to old Fezziwig.
You haven't forgotten.
Yeah. No more work tonight, he'd say. This is Christmas Eve. What a jolly old fellow he was.
As I used to be.
Ebenezer, don't be stingy with the punch. Fill my glass up.
I'm sorry.
Ebenezer, why aren't you dancing?
I'm waiting for Belle.
Imagine, Ebenezer in love.
I'm sorry I'm late, Ebenezer, but we were very busy at the shop.
Hello, darling.
Here's Belle. Now we can have a song.
Oh, nice. Well, if Ebenezer will join in with me.
Give my girl for Christmas. let's all dance the polka.
He made us all happy, old Fesserwig did. I wish...
Your happiness was short-lived. Look again.
But that is not what I meant.
Oh, Ebenezer, I've seen your nobler aspirations fall off one by one. You're changed. You no longer need me.
Have I ever said so?
In words, never. But would you seek me out and try to win me now? No.
You think not?
You weigh everything by its money value. You'd never choose a dowerless girl. Perhaps you will never choose any.
Christmas present. Pluck up your courage. Only good will happen to you.
Christmas present?
Yes. You don't give many of them, do you?
Not of late years, no.
I do. It's my business. None of this will be wasted, you may be sure.
How did you get here?
Oh, I came on my regular rounds.
Spirit, if you have anything to teach me,
I'm ready to learn.
A berry, a merry, a berry, a merry, a merry Christmas. A berry, a merry, a berry, a merry, a merry Christmas day.
Just a trifle too much sage in the dressing.
I can tell from here that it's perfect.
Yes, it is, Mother. Perfect.
How many hours does it take to roast a goose?
That depends on how much it weighs. This one will take several hours more.
Hours? Oh, I wish it were smaller.
I don't. I want lots of goose.
Peter, did you put something in your mouth?
No, Mother.
He's sitting right next to the gingerbread.
I just took a little piece.
Peter, can't you wait until tomorrow?
Peter's impatient.
Father doesn't really mind.
No more I don't. Do I, Tim?
Not a bit of it.
And anyway, I am petting potatoes.
And I'm having Mother with a goose.
Oh, say! You didn't guess the answer to my riddle yet.
Yes, let's finish the
Shall
game.
Shall we do that?
Oh, yes,
wonderful.
Yes, we'll just finish. We'll just finish this one. That's all. Belinda, I think it was your turn.
It's something alive, you said.
Yes.
And it lives
it
in London.
Wait a minute. Wait. Now, one at a time.
Does it live in London?
Yes, it lives in London.
Peter, you're getting warmer. Is it an animal?
Yes.
Does it growl?
Oh, Dragon. Growl.
Is it warm-blooded?
Well, there's been some doubt about that.
Is it a bear?
A bear? Well, not exactly a bear.
Belinda, you ask another question.
Gargoyle!
Eat meat or vegetables?
It eats everything. Meat and vegetables and people and real estate and everything.
Oh, I know what it is.
What?
I know what it
what?
Is.
What? What is it? What is it? Come on, Peter.
It's Mr. Scrooge.
I heard Scrooge's nephew invite him to Christmas dinner, and Scrooge said Christmas was a humbug. Christmas? A humbug?
Enough games for now. Finish the tree, and then Tim must be off to bed.
After you put the star on the top, Tim, it's off to bed, young fellow.
It's too much excitement for him.
Oh, nonsense. On the way home from church, he was so chipper. It's a big, strong man he's going to be. He's getting stronger every day. You'll see many a Christmas after us.
Oh, Bob.
Just a few more shillings a week. I could buy him the right kind of care.
No use fretting about it. A cheerful heart is the best healer.
Back to work, Tim. You shall put the star on the top of the tree.
Dear God,
tiny Tim will live.
My life on this globe is very brief. It ends tonight.
Tell me, will tiny Tim live?
I see a vacant seat in the poor chimney corner and a crutch without an owner, carefully preserved. These shadows may be altered only by the spirit of the future.
Where do I find the spirit of the future?
Look within yourself. For if you continue as you are, the answer is there before you. Look within yourself. For if you continue as you are, the answer is there before you.
The whole thing was a dream. And I'm alive. No fog, no mist. Bright, blessed, stirring cold. Cold piping for the blood to dance to. Golden sunlight, heavenly sky, sweet, fresh air, merry bells. Glorious! Glorious! Hello, boy! What day is it?
What?
What day of the month is it?
Today? Why, it's Christmas Day!
Christmas Day? I haven't missed it. The spirits have done it all in one night.
A merry, 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 merry Christmas!
Every time I watch this thrilling story, well, I can't tell you what a wonderful Christmas feeling it gives me. Don't you agree?
Yes, Mary. In fact, I think Dickens was trying to make us all feel the warmth, the charity, and the goodwill that should stay with us throughout the year. And that has been the inspiration for this original Christmas carol, written especially for our show tonight. It's called The Spirit of Christmas.
Snow shines round about, all now is gleaming, the spirit. No more fear and doubt, follow a feeling, the spirit of Christmas everywhere. Ooh. Now is the time for joyful giving. To give is the way to joyful living.
Want to wish you and the more than 1 million owners of the cars of the Forward Look a wonderful holiday season from all of us here.
And from the 160,000 members of the Chrysler Corporation family and our thousands of dealers across the country.
I wish to withdraw certain remarks I made to you yesterday. I wish to apologize, and I wish to put my name on your list.
Yes, of course, Mr. Scrooge.
You put me down. Put me down for this.
Lord, bless me.
A great many back payments are included in that. I assure you. Bless you. Merry Christmas.
Merry, a very merry Christmas, a very...
Uncle Scrooge.
Fred! I'm rejoining the human race. Save me some mince pie. I'll be back in an hour or so. Merry Christmas!
Cratchit in?
Yes, sir. Will you come in?
I don't wish to intrude, Bob.
Mr. Scrooge.
May I come in?
Well, I hope it's nothing...
Merry Christmas, Bob. A merrier Christmas, Bob, my good fellow, than I've given you in many a year. I'm going to raise your salary, and we'll procure the best of care for Tiny Tim. But we'll discuss all these affairs this very afternoon over a bowl of smoking bishop. May I come in?
Please do.
Hello, my boy.
Are you a friend of Father's?
I certainly am.
It's Christmas, you know.
Yes, that's why I came. Merry Christmas to all of you.
And to you, sir. Welcome to our home.
Thank you.
We were just about to sit down to dinner, sir. Would you join us?
I should love to.
May I take your coat?
Thank you.
There we are. This is Mrs. Cratchit.
Mrs. Cratchit?
And this is my eldest son, Peter.
How do you do, sir?
How do you do?
Peter, are you wearing one of my collars?
Yes, sir. I thought you wouldn't mind on Christmas Day.
Well, I told you about...
You don't mind, do you, Cratchit?
No, don't. Not anymore, I think, sir. This is Belinda.
Belinda.
And Susie.
Susie.
And Martha.
And I'm Tim.
Yes, sir. I know you are.
Would you sit down, sir?
Thank you.
I'm glad you came, sir.
Thank you.
Would you like to hear my Christmas song?
I should love to hear your Christmas song.
Thank you.
And now, on behalf of Chrysler Corporation, Mary Costa and I want to thank all of you for the enthusiastic reception that you've given the five great cars of the Forward Look 56. Now, here is Joan Evans, who's going to tell us something about next week's climax.
Hi, Bill. It's a true story, you know, about my family, the Unsons.
Mm-hmm.
Want to meet my grandfather?
Sure, I'd love to. Oh, now, wait a minute. Brandon DeWilde is your grandfather?
Well, not exactly. Brandon plays Robert Unson at the age of 12.
Oh.
And where did he meet a great-grandmother, Bill? Miss Barbara Hale.
Hi, Bobby. Welcome.
Hello, Bill. You know, Mamie Unson came to America from Scotland in 1865 with her husband, Robert,
uh-huh.
who was played by Leif Erikson.
Leif,
hi, Bobby. Bill. It was a healthy and a happy family until suddenly a carefree boy of 12 was changed into a man faced with grave responsibilities.
Well, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. See you next week on Climax.
Thank you, Bill.
Next week, The Day They Gave Babies Away by Dale Unson, adapted for Climax by Dale and Catherine Unson. And by the way, you'll find a short story version of The Day They Gave Babies Away in this January's issue of Cosmopolitan magazine. This is Bill Lundigan saying thank you, and don't miss it.
Shower of Stars has been brought to you by
Chrysler Corporation. The Forward Look.
Portions of the preceding program were filmed. This is a CBS Television Network production.